when it comes to democracy or electoral processes or the way people get their information in order to participate in the social or political life, artificial intelligence can be an accelerator of how news, for example, is being spread around the world using in particular social media. I think we have all seen in the past couple of years, both in terms of electoral processes, but also in terms of various themes which are important in the public domain, in the debates that are affecting our societies, how often fake news, disinformation have played a very important role in shaping, in the wrong way, public opinion. And this is where, again, technology can be used in a bad way. And therefore, we have to understand the impact of artificial intelligence also in terms of how it works with our democracies. We'll continue our activities and our hearings for the remainder of our mandate. In the plenary of March, we have just obtained an extension of the mandate with an extra 6 months, which will take us to March 2022. So until then, we still have a very heavy agenda, a very heavy calendar of hearings, workshops, debates. We're going to go even more in depth than we have done until now into the various impacts and the benefits and the risks of artificial intelligence. I think what the pandemic has brought was the realization, both for individuals, for societies, but also for governments and policymakers, of the importance of the transformation of our lives, of the digital transformation, basically, of our societies and economies. And artificial intelligence is part of this transformation. It is one piece of technology that actually contributes to this transformation, digital transformation of our lives. And therefore, I think that what the pandemic contributed was to accelerate this rhythm of transformation, also to accelerate the reaction that we have as policymakers to shaping and signposting how we want this technology to evolve and to be part of our lives. The first hearing that we have organized as the special committee AIDA was on the impact of artificial intelligence in the health sector, because this is one of the most tangible results, products, applications that we can see of artificial intelligence, and one that actually affects our lives on a daily basis. So, and from that we can go into absolutely every sector, from transport, aviation, financial services, the security of our transactions online. So all of these domains of activity are being impacted in a good way, but we also have to make sure that we have the right tools in place to address the challenges and the potential risks that such technology can bring. We have just talked about disinformation and fake news and the impact on democracy. This is a risk that has to be addressed. Also, the biases that can creep in the development of artificial intelligence, of the algorithms that are being used as part of artificial intelligence. And we have to make sure that these biases and some of the biases that we have right now in our physical society, let's say, are not being carried over into the digital society of tomorrow. So just a few examples of why we need to be very careful, also be mindful of the risks, and through legislation, through rules, through principles, that we can put the right boundaries to make sure that we cater for these risks in the right way.